Sometimes when you're building a robot, you need to know the orientation of that robot. This is most often used in something like a drone where it can't tilt, so you have to know exactly which orientations it's in. To do that, all robots use something called an IMU. An IMU combines an accelerometer, gyroscope, and magnetometer in order to determine the angle at which it is pointing. This is the IMU we're going to be looking at today. It is an MPU9250. It is a 3-axis device, so it works in all 3 axes and uses all 3 of the sensors I described, the accelerometer, gyroscope, and magnetometer. It uses the accelerometer to tell which way gravity is pulling and uses trigonometry to turn that into an angle. That is our absolute position. Then it uses the gyroscope, which tells you the angular velocity. It uses that and integrates it to create the angular relative position. And then we combine that with the absolute position from the accelerometer, and we get the position we want. In this implementation, I'm not using the magnetometer at all. The reason the magnetometer is there at all is to tell this rotation, because gravity doesn't dictate which direction is pulling like this. Connecting to the Raspberry Pi Pico with the MPU9250 is very simple. It requires 6 wires. It requires a 3.3 volt from the Raspberry Pi Pico, that is from pin 36, to the VCC pin on the MPU9250. It requires a common ground that can be used on any of the grounds from the Pico. I'm using pin 38 here. Then it requires a connection from GPIO4, or pin 6, to the AD0 on the board. It requires a connection from GPIO5, or pin 7, to the chip select, which is NCS. It requires a connection from GPIO6, or pin 9, to the SCL, the S clock, on the MPU9250, and a connection from GPIO7, or pin 10, to the SDA, or serial data. So now that we know how the MPU9250 works and how you connect it to the Pico, let's look at the code that makes it run. I'm not going to go into detail on how any of the actual math works, but if you want to learn more, you can dig into the code. It's all on GitHub. So there are 2 example scripts. There is the object-oriented one in CPP, C++, and the not object-oriented one in straight C. We're going to look at the object-oriented one first because it's a lot easier to understand, and then we're going to look at the not object-oriented example. This here is the object-oriented example. You can see at the start, it includes the mpuobject.h, and in your CMake folder, you need to include the library that you define in here. It creates an object of the MPU and takes in an integer value. What this integer value does is it tells the object how many times to sample from the gyro to calibrate it. The higher it is, the more accurate it will be, but it also takes a very long time. Then down here, this just emits the serial port. If you don't know how that works, I have a video on it. It'll be in the corner right now. And in the main loop, you can see it's just 2 functions from the object. One is MPU update angles. This reads from the actual board and takes the raw values and calculates the angles with it. And then MPU print data prints that out. Let's look at what that actually looks like in a terminal view. Here it is in the Arduino IDE alongside an actual video of what I'm doing. So you can see when I tilt it, it changes in the IDE and it works in 2 directions. Like I said before, since I'm not including the magnetometer, it doesn't detect in the yaw axis. You can also see that there are 2 different values there, the Euler roll and the full roll. The Euler roll, when it gets up to 90 like this, it starts counting backwards, back to 0 at this point. The full roll, instead, is a full 360 degree. So as you roll around, it doesn't go to 90, back to 0, to negative 90 to 0, it just counts from 0 to 360. You can see this also is the same thing for the pitch. Now let's look at the straight C example. The straight C example is a little bit harder to understand because there's not all the nice padding that comes with the object. So at the very start, you have to include MPU9250.h. Then here it's just knitting the serial port. Again, I have another video on that. Then here you need to call start SPI. What this does is it initiates the communication with the MPU, IMU, and it also resets it and sets it up so that it is ready to give the values to the Pico. Then here are just variable declarations, and this calibrates the gyroscope, and I've set it to only run 100 loops. Then you need to calculate the rotation just from acceleration. The acceleration is where gravity is pulling it, and you need to do this to get the absolute position. Because gravity is always pulling in a known direction downwards, it can calculate at what angle it is to the ground. But the gyroscope is relative. It only tells you how you're changing, not where you started. So you need to start with the absolute position from the accelerometer. Then in here, you grab the raw data from the accelerometer and the raw data from the gyroscope, and you apply the gyroscope calibration that we got from Calibrate Gyro up here. Another thing to note, while it's calibrating, you have to leave it perfectly still. Here we call a function from the MPU called CalculateAngles, and it takes in the Euler angles. The Euler angles is an array of integers that you want to get the return from. It takes in the acceleration from the read raw, the gyro from the read raw, and it also takes in the milliseconds since you last computed the angles. The reason you need this is because the gyroscope gives you your angular velocity at that moment, but you need to be able to convert that into how much it's changed, and to do that you need time. Then this function here converts to full, so if you remember, the Euler angles go from 0 to 90 to 0 to negative 90. This converts it to 360, and these four lines here print out the raw acceleration data, the raw gyroscope data, the raw Euler's, and the full roll. And as you can see here, it behaves exactly as it did in the object-oriented example. All the code you saw in this video will be available on GitHub. The link is in the description. If you like this video, be sure to hit the like button. If you want to see more content from me, be sure to subscribe because I have a lot of cool robot videos and a cool animatronic build coming up. And some of those use the Raspberry Pi Pico here. If you want to see more tutorials, I have another playlist on that too. See you next time.